Hello, so now coming to the globin part of the hemoglobin. Okay, so in the previous video I have discussed about that iron part. Okay, so now I am going to discussing about the globin part. Okay, that means that is protein part of the hemoglobin. Okay, because globin is the protein. The globin part is made up of four polypeptide chains, in that two identical alpha chains and two identical beta chains. In normal adult hemoglobin, okay, so in the normal adult hemoglobin, which will be consist of globin portion, no? That is two identical alpha chains and two identical beta chains. In the previous video, I have shown to you know the structure of the heme molecule, right? Then each chain contains a heme in. So one hemoglobin molecule possesses four heme unit. I told you know that four heme molecule, which will be found the one hemoglobin molecule. Okay. So this is all about the structure of hemoglobin, which consists of iron portion and protein portion. Iron portion, which is called the heme, and the protein portion, which is called the globin. Okay. So now I am going to discussing about the synthesis of hemoglobin. Okay. How hemoglobin will be synthesized in our body? Synthesis of hemoglobin actually starts in the proerythroblastic stage. Now question can arise like, what is proerythroblastic stage, right? Actually, whenever in the next class I'll discuss about the synthesis of RBC molecule. Okay, in that time you will get the idea of proerythroblastic stage. Okay, however, hemoglobin appears in the intermediate normoblastic stage only. Then the production of hemoglobin is continued until the stage of reticulocyte. Heme molecule of hemoglobin is synthesized in mitochondria, and the protein part globin is synthesized in the ribosomes. So you have to remember that the heme portion, which will be synthesized in where? Mitochondria. And the protein part, which will be synthesized in the ribosomes. Okay. So this is the most important question. Okay. So now coming to the synthesis of heme. Heme is synthesized from succinyl coenzyme and the glycine. So heme, which will be synthesized from the succinyl coenzyme and the glycine. The sequence of events in synthesis of hemoglobin, like sequence wise, okay, step by step. Number one, first step in heme synthesis take place in the mitochondrion. The heme synthesis in the mitochondrion. Two molecules of succinyl coenzyme combined with the two molecules of glycine. So two molecules of succinyl coenzyme, which will combine with the two molecules of glycine and condense to form amino lavulinic acid by ALS synthase. Okay, so ALS synthase, that means the amino lavulinic acid synthesis. It is nothing but it is enzyme. Okay. So what is happening in the first step? In the first step, two molecules of succinyl coenzyme, which will be combined with the two molecules of glycine molecule. Okay. That two molecules of succinyl coenzyme, which will be combined with the two molecules of glycine. And what it will form? And it will form the amino lavulinic acid. Okay, aminolevulinic acid. How? In the presence of aminolevulinic acid synthase. In the presence of this enzyme, it will form the aminolevulinic acid. Okay, clear? First step. So next, coming to the second step. What is happening in the second step? Okay. So aminolevulinic acid, which is transported to the cytoplasm. Okay. Then in the cytoplasm, two molecules of aminolevulinic acid, which will be combined to form phosphobilinogen in the presence of aminolevulinic acid dehydrates. So again, that aminolevulinic acid, which will combine to form the phosphobilinogen. How it will form? In the presence of this enzyme. That means aminolevulinic acid dehydratase. So you have to remember that this is also another enzyme. So in the presence of this enzyme, the aminolevulinic acid, which will form the phosphobilinogen. Okay. Understood, no? So this is the second step. So next, coming to the third step, that is porphobilinogen, which is converted into the uroporphobilinogen 1. How it will form? By uroporphobilinogen 1 synthesis. Uroporphobilinogen 1 synthesis. This is also another enzyme. So the porphobilinogen, which will convert it into the uroporphobilinogen in the third step. How? In the presence of uroporphobilinogen 1 synthase. Okay. Understood? Next, coming to the fourth step. Here, uroporphobilinogen 1 is converted into the uroporphobilinogen 3 by porphobilinogen 3 co-synthase. So this is the fourth step. So what is happening in the fourth step? In the fourth step, the uroporphobilinogen 1, which will be converted into the uroporphobilinogen 3. How it will form? In the presence of porphobilinogen 3 co-synthase. Okay. Next, coming to the fifth number step. So now we will understand that what is happening in the fifth step. So in the fifth step, the uroporphobilinogen 3, which is a ring structure, which is called the co-proporphobilinogen. Okay. Which is called the co-proporphyrinogen 3, which is formed by uroporphobilinogen decarboxylase. Uroporphobilinogen decarboxylase. This one also another enzyme. Okay. So dear student, you have to remember the terms. Okay. Because it is so difficult to remember. Okay. You have to read properly. Otherwise, you will forget. Okay. So again and again, you have to read it. Just one second. So what is happening in the sixth step? In the sixth step, co-proporphyrinogen 3 is transported back to the mitochondrion. So again, that co-proporphyrinogen 3, which will be transported back to the mitochondrion, where it is oxidized to form the protoporphyrinogen 9 by co-proporphyrinogen oxidase. This is also another enzyme. So in the sixth step, what it will form? It will form the protoporphyrinogen 9. How it will form? In the presence of enzyme. Which enzyme? Co-proporphyrinogen oxidase. Okay. Now, coming to the seventh step, So what is happening in the seventh step? The protoporphyrinogen 9, which is converted into the in the seventh number step, protoporphyrinogen 9, which is converted into the protoporphyrin 9 by protoporphyrinogen oxidase. How it will form? In the presence of protoporphyrinogen oxidase, the protoporphyrinogen 9, which will convert into the protoporphyrin 9. Okay. So, in the 8th step, the protoporphyrin 9, which will combine with the iron to form the heme. In the presence of what? Ferrochelatase. In the presence of ferrochelatase, the protoporphyrin 9, which will combine with the iron to form the heme. So, in the 8th step only, the heme will be formed. Okay, understood, no? So, dear student, if you are having any doubt regarding the synthesis of heme, please ask me the question, okay? If you are getting any doubt. Okay. Thank you.